Let's go, girls.
Right, see, sometimes when I tell people I'm a DJ, they give me a really cool response, like, oh, wow, that must be amazing. And, like, I'm always like, yeah, no, it's pretty cool. It's cool to make money by playing music. And music that I like. But the thing is about mobile DJing is there's a lot of sort of heavy goods work. I'm about to load the speakers onto the trolley and take it to the venue, which is probably... It's two main roads and a disabled lift and many, many rocky, uneven pavements away on a trolley that isn't very stable. So I'm going to take you on my journey just to show you. It's tough. And I'm hot and I don't have anyone to help me. Not that I feel sorry for myself, but it's difficult, you know?
So it didn't work massively well recording the journey with my camera, and several shots were inappropriate given my low cut top. But I did manage with my oversized lady muscles to transport my speakers without having too many of them fall off in the middle of a bus route.
So as you can see, it's not all clean sailing. I had a few incidences. Obviously everyone's watching me. I'm quite hot and flustered. But this is what mobile DJ's like. This is sadly how it is. It'll be worth it when it's all set up. A little eye-opener. Man, I feel like a woman. Okay, so I've set my gig up, all the equipment's up, all the lights and the music are working. I did try and start playing some music, but I got told off by a 70-year-old woman. She seemed quite angry with me, really. So far not going great. I expect in about half an hour, because of this lady, I will be putting some music on, and I think there's a singer as well. Already it's not what I expect. I thought it was going to be a bar in London, and it's like a health centre, which is cool, it's fine. I also feel very naive for ever thinking that it would be daunting going to a radical feminist conference party. One of the great things about being a DJ is you get a lot of party food. So it's the kids stuff, get party rings, sandwiches without crusts on, mini rolls. In here, it looks like there's a nice salad, which is quite different, which I enjoy very much. So I think I'm going to go and get some food.
One delicious salad later, and it was time to get this party started.
Behind the booth, get into the spirit of it. Headphones on. Well, I can check out what music's going on next. And at the moment, we've got a bit of Diana Ross, I'm Coming Out, which is exciting stuff. Because many of the people here have done that at some point in their life. They've come out. I think it's time for the next track.
Next up, it was my first request, and I don't think the lady really knew what she wanted.
I heard you have a lot of music and we can make requests.
Absolutely,
is that right?
Yeah, what would you like?
I have no idea.
Okay, what genre? Are you thinking old school? Are you thinking new school? What do you listen to at home?
I know at this point she'd definitely request something I didn't have.
Phone? F-A-U-N?
This is where people give me... No, I don't have phone. Sorry.
That's all right.
Okay.
Then it all became a bit awkward. She just stood there.
Actually, I should get my friend Katy to come. She knows a lot of great artists. Maybe she'll have an idea.
Okay, cool. Yeah, do that.
Everything she likes, I like. So I gotta.
Okay, cool. Yeah. That's how you handle. A request. Unfortunately, she wasn't able to help her because she didn't know any artists. And the one artist she did ask for, I didn't have, so. It's just luck of the draw, really. 40,000 songs, and sometimes I just don't have them. So, that was me handling that.
And So to the next part of mobile DJing, which is keeping yourself going over 6 hours on your own playing music. And singing is the best way.
Perfect. I'm not bloody perfect. Be
worth it, yeah. If an audience like a song, they usually want to pay more than once. So after playing Carly Rae Jepsen, Gangnam Style, or I Will Survive, five or more times in one evening, the challenge is, can you stop yourself from wanting to take your own life?
Okay guys, now because it's been requested once more, we're going to go on with a little bit more Gloria Gaynor and I Will Survive.
So here's the slightly badly recorded halfway sum up, which is basically saying that it's not what I expected. I have found out that it's part of the politics of radical feminism to be a lesbian, which is quite interesting really. But most of all, I've learnt that it's just a normal party that has a mixture of ages in. The oldies want the old school, the youngers want the chart, and I'm like the diplomat juggling the requests. So from Madonna to Pink to Dusty Springfield, I went to reggae. And every time someone hears a song they're not really into, I'm shot daggers behind the DJ booth. So yeah, it's fun, but it's a challenge to keep them all happy.
Had your requests answered. I've done my best, and have a safe journey home.
And that's the end. Just like that.
Okay, so it's the end of the night. It's 1:45, and it's been a good night. It's definitely changed my perceptions. I was naive to ever think that it would be very different from a normal gig. It was interesting. Everyone was much more opinionated than in my usual gigs, and maybe a tiny bit less forgiving. But as there was a large range of ages, I had to mix and match it quite a lot. So it was always going to be like that. Gigs like that are always really hard because one minute you have to play in 60s, next minute you're having to play the current chart music. So with that and the added restriction of only being able to play female music, which I did not always do, I think it went well and everyone was happy. I've now got to a stage where I actually can't bring words out because I'm too tired. Saying that, I potentially am just going to go to a friend's house now for a little drink. So party never stops when you're DJ Sophie. I hope that today I've shown you a little bit about what I do. And maybe showing you that it's not as glamorous as sometimes it sounds. But I'm pretty knackered, so hurrah.
And there we have it. Just a nice little shot of me driving home. Till next time, amigos.